Good morning, children. Welcome to the third session of Chapter 3, Pair of Linear Equation in Two Variables. In the previous session, we have discussed about the general form of a pair of linear equation, and you find out the relation between the ratios of the coefficient of the two equations and whether the lines are intersecting, are parallel, are coincident. And you studied about consistency of the lines. Now, in this part, you are going to discuss about the three algebraic methods for finding the solution of the equation. Algebraic methods for finding the solution of a pair of linear equation. In that, the first one is substitution method, second one is elimination method, and third one is cross multiplication method. In this session, we are discussing about the substitution method. In substitution method, if the algebraic equations are given, first you have to find the value of one of the two variables. For example, you take the variable y from either of the equation, that is, you are taking from equation 1 in terms of x. Then substitute this value in the other equation, that is in the equation 2, to get a linear equation in x. Then solve the equation and get the value of x. Then you have to substitute the value of x in the expression for y in terms of x, you will get the value of y. So the solution of the pair of equation, that is the value of x and y, you will get by this method. You can make it more clear by doing the sum. Moving to exercise 3.3. Question number 1, solve the pair of linear equation by substitution method. In that, question number 1, x plus y equal to 14 and x minus y equal to 4. That is, two equations are given. So first step, we have to number the equation, that is x plus y equal to 14. You number the equation as 1 and x minus y equal to 4, number the equation as 2. Now, from equation 1, you have to write the equation in terms of y or x. For example, I am writing in terms of x, that is x equal to 14 minus y. You number this as the third equation. Now, what you are going to do is substitute equation 3. Substitute equation 3 in equation 2. That is, instead of x, you have to write 14 minus y minus, because second equation is x minus y equal to 4. So x is 14 minus y, and y you have to write as it is equal to 4. That is 14 minus minus y minus y, that is minus 2y equal to 4. Then you will get 14 minus 4 equal to 2y, or you can write it as y equal to 10 upon 2 equal to 5. So you are getting the value of y as 5. So you write down, therefore, y equal to 5. Now you have to get the value of x. For that, substitute y equal to 5 in equation 3. So you are getting x equal to 14 minus y. Y is 5, so you substitute that. That is equal to 9. Therefore, x equal to 9. Therefore, the solution of the equation is x equal to 9 and y equal to 5. So you got the solution of the equation as x equal to 9 and y equal to 5. You can verify whether the answer you got, the value of x and y, are correct or not. You have to just substitute the value of x and y in any one of the equation. For example, x plus y equal to 14. You just check whether 9 plus 5, that is 14. That means the value of x and y is correct. Question number 2. F minus t equal to 3 and s upon 3 plus t upon 2 equal to 6. The first step is you are numbering the equation, that is f minus t equal to 3. Number it as equation 1 and s upon 3 plus t upon 2 equal to 6. Number the equation as 2. Now, from equation 1, you can write in terms of s or t, I am writing s equal to 3 plus t. Number the equation as 3. Now, the next step, you have to substitute s equal to 3 plus t in equation 2. So, please write, substitute equation 3 in equation 2. That is, s upon 3, instead of s, you have to write it as 3 plus t upon 3 plus t upon 2 equal to 6. Now, since these are in fractional forms, you take the LCM, you will have 2 multiplied by 3 plus t plus 3 multiplied by t upon 6 equal to 6. That is, 2 3s are 6 plus 2t plus 3t equal to 6 multiplied by 6. That is 36. So, you are having 6 plus 5t equal to 36. You can again write, therefore, t equal to 36 minus 6 upon 5, that is 30 upon 5, that is 6. You are getting t equal to 6. Now, substitute t equal to 6 in which equation? Equation number 3. You will get s equal to 3 plus t is 6. That is 3 plus 6, 9. Therefore, s equal to 9. So, the equations are having the variables s and t. Therefore, the solution is s equal to 9 and t equal to 6. Question number 5. Root 2x plus root 3y equal to 0 and root 3x minus root 8y equal to 0. First step, you number the equation, that is root 2x plus root 3y equal to 0, that is equation number 1, and root 3x minus root 8y equal to 0, that is equation number 2. Since the second equation is having minus sign, it is better you from equation 2, you can write it as root 3x equal to root 8y. That is, x equal to root 8 upon root 3y. You number the equation as 3. Since from equation 2, you are taking x, you have to substitute equation 3 in equation 1. Substitute equation 3 in equation 1. That is, root 2 x is root 8 upon root 3y plus root 3y equal to 0. So the equation comes in terms of y. Root 2 multiply by root 8, that is 2 multiply by 8 upon root 3y plus root 3y equal to 0. 2 multiply by 8 is 16. Square root of 16 means 4. So you will get it as 4 upon root 3y plus root 3y equal to 0. That is, you can write it as, since y is a common term, you can take it y outside, y multiply by 4 upon root 3 plus root 3 equal to 0. From this, it is clear 4 upon root 3 plus root 3 is not equal to 0. Therefore, only one condition is arrived, that is y equal to 0. Because the product of y and 4 root 3 plus root 3 is 0. And we know that 4 upon root 3 plus root 3 is not equal to 0. So, only thing possible is y equal to 0. Now, substitute y equal to 0 in equation 3. So you are getting x equal to root 8 upon root 3 multiply by y is 0. That is, any number multiply by 0 is 0. That is, you are getting x equal to 0. Therefore, the solution of the equation, that is, therefore, the solution is x equal to 0 and y equal to 0. We got the solution as x 0. Now, equation number 2, solve 2x plus 3y equal to 11 and 2x minus 4y equal to minus 24, and hence find the value of m for which y equal to mx plus 3. Here, two equations are given and You have to find the solution for that equation and you have to get the value of m after substituting the values of x and y in the given equation y equal to mx plus 3. So first step is you take the first two equation and number it, that is 2x plus 3y equal to 11. You number it as equation number 1. 2x minus 4y equal to minus 24. Number the equation as 2. So from equation 1, you will get x equal to 11 minus 3y upon 2. You number the equation as 3. Now substitute equation 3 in equation 2, because from equation 1 you have get the value of x, so that value you have to substitute in equation 2, that is 2 multiply by x is 11 minus 3y upon 2 minus 4y equal to minus 24. That is, you take the LCM as, or you can cancel the 2 here. So you are getting 11 minus 3y minus 4y equal to minus 24. That is 11 minus 7y equal to minus 24. 11 plus 24 equal to 7y. That is y equal to 24 plus 11, that is 35 upon 7, that is 5. So you are getting y equal to 5. Now substitute y equal to 5 in equation 1. In equation 3, you will get x equal to 11 minus 3 multiplied by 5 upon 2. That is 11 minus 15 upon 2. That is minus 4 upon 2. That is minus 2. So you are getting x equal to minus 2. Therefore, the solution is x equal to minus 2 and y equal to 5. Now you have to get the value of m. For that, putting x equal to minus 2 and y equal to 5 in y equal to mx plus 3. That is, y is 5, 5 equal to m multiplied by x is minus 2 plus 3. From this you will get 5 minus 3 equal to minus 2m. Therefore, m equal to 2 upon minus 2, that is minus 1. So you are getting the value of, therefore, m equal to minus 1. Question number 3. Form the pair of linear equation for the following problem and find their solution by substitution method. In that, first one, the difference between two numbers are 26 and one number is 3 times the other. Find them. Here, the mathematical statement is given, first you have to frame the equations. So the first step, you have to find the unknowns. Here the question is about two numbers, so you have to take the two numbers x and y and mention which number is greater. That is, we are taking, let the two numbers be x and y, and x is greater than y. Then it is given the difference between the two numbers is 26. From that you are getting the first equation as x minus y equal to 26, and number the equation as 1. And the second condition is given, one number is 3 times the other. That means x equal to 3 times y. So you number the equation as x equal to 3y, that is equation number 2. Since you are having two equations and the second equation is in terms of x, you can directly substitute equation 2 in equation 1. So you are getting, instead of x you write down 3y minus y equal to 26, that is 2y equal to 26, y equal to 26 upon 2, that is 13. So you are getting y equal to 13. Now you have to get the value of x. For that, substitute y equal to 13 in equation 2. So you are getting x equal to 3y, that is 3 multiply by 13, that is 39. Therefore x equal to 39. Therefore the required two numbers are, therefore the two numbers are 39 and y equal to 13. You can check the answer by yourself. The difference is given 26, that is 39 minus 13, that is 26 only. That means our solution is correct. Question number 2. The larger of two supplementary angles exceed the smaller by 18 degrees, find them. Here the two unknowns are the two angles. They are forming supplementary angles. Supplementary angle means the sum of the two angles is 180 degree. And the other condition is given, the larger angle exceed the smaller by 18 degree. So first we have to take, let the larger and smaller of two supplementary angles be x and y respectively, x degree and y degree respectively. So you will have, according to the first condition, you will get x equal to y plus 18 degree, and the second condition is they are supplementary, that means x plus y equal to 180 degree. Supplementary angles means the sum of the two angles is 180 degree. Now, since the first equation is given in terms of x, you can directly substitute equation 1 in equation 2. So please write, substitute equation 1 in equation 2, and you are getting, instead of x, you have to write y plus 18 degree plus y equal to 180 degree, 2y equal to 180 degree minus 18 degree, that is 162 degree. Therefore, y equal to 162 degree upon 2, that is 81 degree. You are getting y equal to 81 degree. Now you have to get what is x. For that, substitute y equal to 81 degree in equation 1. You will get x equal to y plus 18 degree, that is y is 81 degree plus 18 degree, that is 99 degree. Therefore, x equal to 99 degree. Therefore, the two angles are,81 degree and 99 degree. You can check the answer by yourself, because these two angles are forming supplementary. That means the sum of 81 and 99, that is 180. So the answer is correct. Question number 4. The taxi charges in a city consist of a fixed charge together with the charge for a distance covered. For a distance of 10 km, a charge paid is ₹105, and for a journey of 15 km, the charge paid is ₹155. What are the fixed charges and the charge per kilometer? How much does a person have to pay for traveling a distance of 25 km? Now here the mathematical statement is given. First, you have to frame the equation. For framing the equation, you have to find which are the two unknowns you have to find in this question. That is, the two unknowns are fixed charge and charge per kilometer. So, let the fixed charge be rupees X and the charge per kilometer be rupees Y. And the first condition it is given, for a distance of 10 kilometers, the charge paid is ₹105. That is, according to the question, if x is the fixed charge, so x plus 10 multiplied by the charge per kilometer, that is 10y, equal to ₹105. And from the second condition, for a journey of 15 kilometers, the charge paid is ₹155. So, you will get the next equation as x plus 15y equal to 2. Now, you have to find the solution of x and y by substitution method. So, the first step is from equation 1, you can write the equation in terms of x, that is x equal to 105 minus 10y. Number the equation as 3. Substitute equation 3 in equation 2, because from the first equation you are taking the x, so you have to substitute x in the second equation. So, you will have, instead of x, you have to write 105 minus 10y plus 15y equal to 155. That is, minus 10y plus 15y, that is 5y equal to 155 minus 105, that is 50. Therefore, y equal to 50 upon 5, that is 10. From this you will get y equal to 10. Now to get the value of x, you have to substitute y in equation 3. Substitute y equal to 10 in equation 3. That is, x equal to 105 minus 10y. 10 multiplied by y is 10. That is, 105 minus 100, that is equal to 5. So you are getting x, that is the fixed charge, equal to rupees 5, and y, that is charge per kilometer, that is rupees 10. Now, how much does a person have to pay for traveling a distance of 25 kilometers? So, for 25 kilometer journey, x, that is the fixed charge, plus 25 kilometer he is traveling, multiply by charge per kilometer, that is y, that is equal to x you find out as 5 plus 25 multiply by 10, that is equal to 5 plus 250, that is 255. Therefore, charge paid for ...25 kilometer journey is rupees 255. Don't forget to write the conclusion when you are solving the sum. Question number 5. A fraction becomes 9 upon 11 if 2 is added to both numerator and denominator. If 3 is added to both numerator and denominator, it becomes 5 upon 6. Find the fraction. So here you have to find the fraction. Fraction is having the numerator and denominator. So first you have to take, let x be the numerator and y be the denominator of the fraction. Therefore, the required fraction is x upon y. And it is given in the first condition, a fraction becomes 9 upon 11 if 2 is added to both numerator and denominator. That is, you have to add 2 to the numerator and denominator, then you are getting the fraction 9 upon 11. So you can frame the equation according to the first condition, that is x plus 2 upon y plus 2 equal to 9 upon 11. Now you do the cross multiplication, so you can get it as x plus 2 multiply by 11 equal to 9 multiply by y plus 2. Removing the brackets, you will have 11x plus 22 equal to 9y plus 18. That is, 11x minus 9y equal to 18 minus 22, that is 11x minus 9y equal to 18 minus 22, that is minus 4. So you number this equation as 1. Now, according to the second condition, the equation formed is, if 3 is added to both numerator and denominator, the fraction becomes 5 upon 6, that is x plus 3 upon y plus 3 equal to 5 upon 6. By simplifying this fraction, you will get x plus 3 multiplied by 6 equal to 5 multiplied by y plus 3. So you will have 6x plus 18 equal to 5y plus 15. That is 6x minus 5y equal to 15 minus 18. That is 6x minus 5y equal to minus 3. You number the equation as equation number 2. Now you have got two equations. You have to solve and get the value of x and y. Now you have got two equations, that is 11x minus 9y equal to minus 4. That is the first equation. Second is 6x minus 5y equal to minus 3. That is second equation. So you are using substitution method to find x and y. So from equation 1, I'm going to write the equation in terms of x. So I can write x equal to minus 4 plus 9y upon 11. Number this equation as 3. Now you have to substitute equation 3 in equation 2. That is 6 multiplied by x is minus 4 plus 9y upon 11 minus 5y equal to minus 3. Take the LCM as 11, you will have 6 multiplied by minus 4 plus 9y minus 5 multiplied by 11 is 55y equal to minus 3 multiplied by 11 is 33. That is 6 fours are minus 24 plus 6 nines are 54y minus 55y equal to minus 33 plus 54y minus 55y, that is minus 1y, yeah, you can write y equal to minus 33 plus 24, that is minus y equal to minus 33 plus 24, that is minus 9. So you can write it as y equal to 9. Now you got the value of y, you have to get the value of x. For that you have to substitute y equal to 9 in equation 3. That is x equal to minus 4 plus 9, y means 9, 9 multiplied by 9 upon 11. That is minus 4 plus 81 upon 11. That is 77 upon 11. That is equal to 7. So you are getting x equal to 7. Now the required fraction, therefore the required fraction required fraction. We have taken the fraction as x upon y, that is equal to x is 7 upon y is 9. So you got the answer as 7 upon 9. Moving to homework, in exercise 3.3, the sums that we have discussed in the class, that you have to write it in your notebook, and the questions that I have given here, that you have to do it as homework. Thank you.